Hello, I am Carly McAvoy. Today we're talking about translating. This is actually more practice because we've done translating before and this is a chance just to practice it again. Translate the following phrase to an algebraic expression. A number subtracted from negative 3. What goes first here, the number or negative 3? Well, we're subtracting a number from negative 3. So we start with negative 3, and we're subtracting a number from that. Let's say our number is x. It could be any variable. It doesn't say what variable to use, but it looks like that when you translate it. The second one, see if you can do this before I do. The difference of 6 and 4 times a number. Well, when you're finding the difference of something, whoops, I'm going the wrong way. When you're finding the difference of something, you are doing a subtraction problem again. And when you say the word difference, the order matters. Since we said difference, we need to say what comes first in our statement, and that is 6. So it has to be 6. And then we're subtracting 4 times a number. What does 4 times a number look like? Well, it could look like 4n. That's the difference of 6 and 4 times a number. All right, the product of negative 2 and the sum of a number and negative 3. Well, we're talking about a product. So overall, we're talking about multiply. So we're going to multiply negative 2 times the sum. So we're going to multiply negative 2 times a quantity that is an addition problem. That's what that looks like. The product of negative 2 and a sum means we're taking negative 2 and multiplying it times the sum. And the sum that we have is a number and negative 3. So a number, I could say, is y, and then negative 3, like that. So that is the product of negative 2 and the sum of a number and negative 3. Now, could this thing, or does this thing, look like this? Could it equal this, I mean? Negative 2 and then y minus 3. Because plus a negative would be the same as subtract 3. And in fact, it is the same, but when you're translating, you want to translate it not to some other simplified version, but you want to translate what they say. And since they said it this way, that's how I would do it, even though I probably am past the point of putting plus a negative like that. But that's what it said, so that's how I would answer that question. The quotient of the sum of a number and 8 and negative 2. Now, in this case, we're talking about overall the first operation is a quotient. So that means I want to write it like this. That's my division symbol, fraction bar in this case. There's two things involved here. We have a sum, and that's stated first. So I know I'm going to have a sum on the top. And so the first thing I want to do is figure out what is part of my sum. Well, I have a number, which I wrote number, but we know it's number, and 8. So that looks like whatever you want it to be, q plus 8. That's a sum of a number and 8. Now remember, it's a quotient, so that's only the numerator. What's the other part? The other part is negative 2. So in the denominator, we have negative 2. It's a quotient, so it's a division problem. There's a sum, so it's addition on the top. And finally, there's negative 2 down below. Okay, quick brief review,